Hi, I am Ufumao Gaga from Goshen Bookkeeping and Consulting. To wrap up our four-part church series on restricted funds, I will show you how to close out your year-end fund balances to your net asset accounts on the statement of financial position. If you have been using QuickBooks Online for a while, you will notice every year on January the 1st or the beginning of your fiscal year, your net surplus or deficit from all of your fund balances closes to the QuickBooks retained earnings equity account. To get accurate fund balances, you need to move all of the fund balances from the retained earnings equity account to the with or without donor restriction net asset accounts. Let's go into QuickBooks Online to complete this step. Going into the Report Center, I'll select the Statement of Activity by Class Report, and I'll change the date range to the prior year and click Run Reports to get our fund balances. I'll make a note of each fund balance amount and the total net surplus amount because we're going to use those numbers to record our journal entry later. Here's our Statement of Financial Position report for the same period to show you the same net surplus amount. Now I will change the report's date range to January 1st so that you can see my net surplus amount has rolled into the retained earnings equity account. Here's a flow chart for you to understand what's happening with my net surplus account and retained earnings so that you know how to record your journal entry. The retained earnings and the net asset accounts on your statement of financial position are the accumulated net worth of your ministry throughout the years. When you have a net surplus, that increases the retained earnings equity account. To clear the balance from the retained earnings equity account, you need to debit that account and credit your with or without donor restriction net asset account. If you have a net deficit from your statement of activities for the prior year, you need to do the reverse journal entry of what I just stated. Hopefully this chart helps you understand where to plug your numbers when recording your journal entry. Now let's record our beginning fund balances. Enter January 1st or the beginning date of your fiscal year as the journal entry date, and continue with your journal entry number sequence. For line 1, select the journal clearing accounts we created before. Enter a description, leave the name field blank. Select the without donor restriction location tracking and the general fund class. For line 2, select the retained earnings account. Enter the net surplus amount in the debit box. Repeat the same description from above and select the customer and project in the name field. Select with donor restriction if you are using location tracking and the temporary restricted class. For line 3, select the with donor restriction temporary net asset account. Enter the net surplus amount in the credit box. Repeat the same description from above and select the customer and project in the name field. Under the location tracking field, select with donor restriction and the temporary restricted class. If you have other funds to record, repeat the entire process, making sure you add the amounts in the correct boxes using our journal entry flowchart explanation until your retained earnings account is zero. Copy the same description from above to the memo field at the bottom and click Save and Close. Let's refresh the Statement of Financial Position for January 1st. You will notice the retained earnings account is zero, and the with and without donor restriction net asset accounts now have all of the fund balances we recorded. This concludes my four-part series on how to record and track restricted funds for your ministry in QuickBooks Online. Let me know if this video helped you in the comment section and what other topics you would like to see me cover next. Don't forget to check out the description box for a link to the full playlist for my QuickBooks Online for Churches video series.